Now, Rachel Garceau with the On Your Side forecast.
It is 6:49 on your Monday morning. So as we inch closer to the summer solstice on Friday, I want to clear up a little bit of confusion about two summer terms or seasonal terms that we throw around as meteorologists. So we have meteorological seasons and astronomical seasons. So meteorological summer actually kicked off on June 1st. So our meteorological seasons are based on the calendar and on our temperature cycle. So January, February, March is the winter season. And then you have spring is March, April, May, and it continues on like that. So meteorological summer is June, July, and August, are typically warmest months of the year. And this just helps in calculating seasonal statistics and tracking data. Keeping it in those 90-day chunks makes it really easy to keep track of. Now, when we say first day of summer, most folks think astronomical summer, that longest day of the year, the summer solstice, which is this Friday, June 21st. 9:54 a.m. is technically when the solstice happens, but that will be our most daylight we'll have all year long. And this is based on the rotation of the Earth around the sun, and our solstices and our equinoxes mark the seasons instead of just the calendar. So when we say first day of summer, sometimes there's two meanings, but I know the general public, we normally mean that summer solstice, and that is happening on Friday. Now, ironically, by the end of the week, we have our coolest weather of the extended period. So Mother Nature has her seasons a little flip-flopped as we're starting off the final week of spring with hot conditions, and then Wednesday is kind of our transition day before that cooler air comes in on Thursday. So here's the area of low pressure that will be our weather maker, our weather changer by the end of the week. But for today and tomorrow, still very hot and sunny, a little stormy at times as well. We still have some mid-level moisture hanging out, and that could trigger some storms at our higher elevations today. We had a couple of lightning strikes and some showers coming down just outside Sun Valley earlier this morning. All is quiet now, but we may see the return of some of those storms by this afternoon. Again, favoring the higher elevations, not completely out of the question in some of the lower valleys, but we most likely will just see hot and mostly sunny conditions, a little breezy at times, which will be welcome when you have temperatures like these. 93 for Vail and Weezer today, 91 expected in Emmett, flirting with 90 in places like Boise, Cuna, and Mountain Home today, with that wind about 10 to 15 miles per hour out of the northwest. As you head up in elevation, still very warm in the Boise Mountains. We're looking at 84 for Idaho City, 87 in Garden Valley today. Beautiful in McCall, Donnelly, and Cascade, just gorgeous with those highs up around 80 degrees or so. A slim chance of a stray storm in the west central mountains. And again, that chance increases as you head east, but still lovely outside of the storm activity today, with 73 for Stanley and Sun Valley and 79 degrees with partly cloudy skies in Fairfield. Beautifully sunny and warm in the Magic Valley, 87 for Gooding and 84 expected in Twin Falls today with just some light winds. So tomorrow our temperatures stay very hot, but you'll notice that wind picking up in response to that approaching system. So by Wednesday, a high of 80 degrees. Thursday, just 70 with the second cold front coming in. First day of summer Friday, still cool, but not bad. 72 degrees and partly cloudy.